Rabbets, or rebates as some folks call them, are essential woodworking joints. They add glue surface for a stronger bond, and they make project parts easier to align and assemble when you're applying your clamps. But it's not just about the rabbet itself. The skills required to make a good rabbet joint are transferable to other parts of woodworking, including more advanced joinery. So if you take the time to learn how to make perfect rabbet joints, you'll become a better woodworker overall. So in this video, I'll teach you some tips that you may not have known about making table saw rabbets, including how to do it with a single cut method with a dado set and a double cut method, which uses a regular blade. I'll also show you some easy to make jigs that will really up your rabbeting game. So let's begin with single cut rabbets. I recommend you watch this part even if you don't have a dado set, because some of these tips also apply to the double cut non-dado set method, which we're going to discuss next. I'm not going to go into how to set up your dado set for your material. We have a separate video full of tips on that, which I'll link to below. It's really good. You should check it out. Once your dado set is installed, you have to decide how to position your fence. Some folks like to cut with the workpiece between the fence and the blade. I'm not a fan of this method for two reasons. First, you don't have the benefit of a riving knife when using a dado set. And if this panel twists during the cut, there's a small chance of a kickback. But the biggest reason I don't like this method is because many projects require a lot of rabbets. And while the width and the depth of the rabbet may be the same throughout the project because you're working with the same material thickness, the width of your individual project parts may vary. By placing the blade next to the fence, you eliminate the need to change your setup for your different size project parts. Of course, you can't put the fence right next to the blade unless you want to damage the fence face. You'll need a sacrificial fence like this one. It's simply a strip of good plywood that's held against the fence with clamps. These fence-style clamps are really handy, not just for this, but for all sorts of other uses in the shop. I'll put a link to some below this video. The first time you use your sacrificial fence, you'll clamp it on and then raise your dado set up into it. You may feel the urge to crank that blade all the way up. Don't do it. Almost every rabbet that you ever cut will be less than an inch deep. There's no need to open up a large cutout on your sacrificial fence when you don't have to. Setting the proper blade height is a lot easier if you know where the center of your blade is, so take the time to mark it on the throat insert. This will save you a lot of hassle for all sorts of table saw tasks. When you know where the apex of your blade is, you can use it to set your blade height accurately, but don't set it to the full height yet. Good joinery is all about sneaking up on the right settings. So I intentionally set my blade a little bit low. I also intentionally set my fence to expose a little less of the blade's width than my rabbet will require. Then I cut the first rabbet in two or three passes, making small adjustments to the width and the height of the dado set until the fit's perfect. I can't stress enough how important it is to sneak up on the proper settings through test cuts. This is a fundamental principle of woodworking. Rulers are great, but your eyes are not perfect. Good joinery of all types require test cuts, and the initial fussing that you'll have to go through can pay off big, because once you get that first joint set up, you can then cut all the rest of the same joints in the project at that same setting with the confidence that they will all be just as perfect. As you cut, apply firm downward pressure as well as lateral pressure sideways against the fence. Dado sets in particular create momentum. They may lift the workpiece, especially at the beginning and the end of the cut. And workpieces that aren't perfectly flat can also lead to inconsistent joinery. So push blocks with nice grippy bottoms make it a lot easier to apply pressure in two directions, downward on top of the saw and sideways against the fence. You may even take a second pass just to be sure that the rabbet was cut to a consistent width and depth along the entire edge. If you're cutting a rabbet on the end of a narrow workpiece, you must use a miter gauge or a sled to keep the part perpendicular to the fence during the cut. It is perfectly safe to use your miter gauge in conjunction with the rip fence in this case, because we aren't creating a loose offcut. Everything is getting turned into sawdust. You would not use a miter gauge and rip fence together if you were cutting something off, like you were making a crosscut all the way through the workpiece, because that loose offcut can then become trapped between the blade and the fence and kick back at you. Now, what if you don't have a dado set? Or You don't want to take the time to set one up. You can use the double cut method if you have a regular saw blade. I say regular blade, meaning a combination blade or something with some flat ground teeth on it. A rip blade would be ideal because all of its teeth are flat ground, which will give your rabbit a nice crisp corner. The first step in a double cut rabbit is to cut the shoulder. Again, sneak up on it, both in blade height and distance from the fence. You may notice that this time I'm cutting with the fence away from the blade, on the opposite side of the panel. There are a couple reasons for this. First, I have my riving knife installed now, which makes kickback very unlikely. But this orientation also allows me to use the masking tape trick. That's a way of micro-adjusting your panel by applying one layer of tape at a time right to your fence. That nudges the panel over and adjusts the width of your rabbit, and that can be easier to make fine adjustments than trying to nudge the fence over itself. Once you're dialed in, you're ready to move on to the second part of the double cut rabbit. For this, I use another sacrificial fence. This one is just like the other, except there is a second taller panel on the outside to help support wide work pieces on edge. You can make this one yourself too, but here's a tip. Don't glue the two layers together. You may need to add shims or tape between them to get that fence perpendicular to your table saw. As you make this cut, be sure that the waste falls away from the fence so it doesn't get caught between the fence and the blade and become a projectile. Also, notice how I use a push block to apply even pressure near the cut. I'm pressing against the fence and down toward the table. Again, a good grippy block is key here. I'll link to some below this video. We're almost done. There's one more jig that will make your life easier. This is a simple tenon jig that slips on top of your table saw fence. It's wide enough to slide down the length of the fence easily, but without any side-to-side play. This jig makes it safer to create double-cut rabbets on the end of narrow work pieces. Now, how can these rabbeting skills help you in other areas of woodworking? Well, think about it. Isn't a dado or a groove just a rabbet moved away from the edge? Half laps are just a pair of mating rabbets. Tenons are double-sided or four-sided rabbets. Even a bridle joint is a double rabbet inside an inside-out rabbet. If you perfect your rabbeting skills by sneaking up on the fit, applying even pressure throughout the cut, and using the right jigs, you can then transfer those same skills to other parts of woodworking and become a better woodworker overall. See you next time. We couldn't do what we do without folks like the Bushy family over at Clearview Cyclones. Not only do they make the best dust collection cyclones on the market, but they're woodworkers supporting woodworkers. They're the sponsor of this video, and I really hope you'll thank them by visiting their website and using our discount code below this video.